This video is about how to feed a baby bird. In this video, we will discuss what you need to do if you find a baby bird, how you should take care of it, what to feed it, and how to feed it. So keep watching this video till the end. It is normal for some species of birds to leave their nest and spend a few days on the ground before they can learn to fly properly. This is a vital part of the young bird's natural development. The parents' birds protect and take care of their babies while they are on the ground. They also teach them vital life skills like finding food, identifying predators, and flying. Such baby birds should not be taken into captivity, as it denies them the opportunity to learn skills which they will need to survive in the wild. Unless you are sure that a bird is injured or orphaned, only then you can take it to a vet clinic for treatment or in captivity to save it. If a bird fell from its nest too early, the best thing to do is to return the bird to its nest. If the nest has been destroyed or is beyond your reach, take a small basket or a box lined with tissue and suspend it from a branch near to where the nest was. Birds have a very strong parental instincts, so they will usually continue caring for their young. Do keep in mind that adult birds are very cautious after any type of disturbance in their nest. They may take several hours for approaching the nestling. During this period, you may not approach the nestling. Fledglings are typically fully feathered baby birds with a short tail and wings. They can walk, hop, and attempt short flights. However, they are still being cared for by the parents. If you find a fledgling on the ground, leave it alone. Keep people and pets away so that its parents will continue to care for it until it can fly. Do not move the fledglings to new locations, as they are still dependent on their parents for survival and will quickly starve. You should only raise wild birds in captivity as a last resort when you are sure that the baby bird is injured or orphaned. It may seem the best option to raise young birds in captivity, but birds raised without learning from their parents have less chance of survival when they are released in the wild. Birds need to be cared for by a certified person. Your vet clinic can check the bird for injuries and contact the right person to continue caring for it. In case there is no vet nearby or a certified person to care of the baby bird, then you may proceed to take care of the baby bird. Keep these points in mind when doing so. Number 1. Baby birds need to be kept warm, day and night. For new hatchlings, the ideal temperature is 32 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. For 10 days old, it must be around 30 degrees Celsius, and when it is half feathered, then 26 degrees Celsius to 28 degrees Celsius. A fully feathered fledgling can maintain its own body temperature, but may need to be kept warm in case it is weak or cold. Keep the baby bird in a small box lined with tissue or paper towels. Punch air holes in the box for ventilation. You can keep the box for warm by placing a hot water bottle or heat pad under it. Check the temperature regularly to ensure it's not too hot or too cold. Baby birds have very demanding feeding schedules. Just like its parents, you must feed the baby bird every 15 to 20 minutes, from sunrise to sunset. Change the feeding frequency to 30 to 45 minutes, when the baby bird has opened its eyes and sprouted some feathers. After that, you can gradually increase the amount of food per feeding and reduce the number of feeding times accordingly. Once the baby bird is strong enough to leave the nest and begins hopping around the box, you can change the feeding frequency to an hour. You can then gradually change the feeding frequency to 2 to 3 hours and begin to leave bits of food in the box for the bird to feed itself. For a recently hatched altricial bird, make food that consists of 60% puppy or kitten kibble, 20% hard-boiled eggs, and 20% mealworms. You can purchase these online. Moisten the kibble with water until it becomes a sponge. Make sure water is not dripping from it, as the baby bird can drown in the excess fluid. Chop the hard-boiled eggs and mealworms into pieces that are small enough for the baby bird to swallow. As the baby bird grows and starts hopping around, you can begin to vary its diet by feeding it the type of food it will eat as an adult. Feed insect-eating birds with chopped earthworms, grasshoppers, and crickets. Feed fruit-eating birds with berries, grapes, and raisins soaked in water. A special diet is required for babies of doves and pigeons, parrots, hummingbirds, fish-eating birds, birds of prey, and any precocial chicks. Doves, pigeons, and parrot-like birds are usually fed pigeon milk, a substance regurgitated by the mother. To replicate this, you need to feed a hand-feeding formula designed for parrots. It is easily available at pet supply stores. You can feed it through a plastic syringe without the needle. Hummingbirds need a specialized nectar formula. Fish-eating birds will need chopped-up minnows. Birds of prey will eat insects, rodents, and smaller chicks. Baby precocial birds will do well on turkey or game bird starter. Do not feed baby birds milk or bread. Milk is not a natural part of a bird's diet, and bread will not provide the baby bird with the nutrients it needs to survive. Also, make sure to serve the food at room temperature. Feed the baby birds very carefully. Use dull tweezers or a plastic forceps. If these are not available, a narrow chopstick that fits in the bird's mouth will do the job. Always drop a small amount of food into the baby's mouth using the tweezers, forceps, or the chopstick. If the baby's is not opening its mouth, tap its beak lightly with the feeding tool or rub the food around the edge of its beak. This lets the bird know that it's time to feed. Feed the bird till it's refused to open its beak or starts rejecting the food. Remember, do not overfeed the chicks. Do not give water to baby birds, as it may fill their lungs and cause them to drown. Place water in jar lids for them when they are old enough to hop around the box. Hand-rearing a baby bird can take a number of weeks and a lot of effort. In many cases, hand-rearing is not successful, but when it can be a rewarding experience. I hope you find this video helpful. Please do not forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos.